Now you see, I can have from this table, I can have this set. These are all sets. This one is also a set. Now I can have another set. I can make a set which will be a subset of all this. Okay. I can make a set which will comprise each and every element of all these sets. Like one this, then one this, then one this, this one, this one, this one, and any more thing? And the tray. Isn't it? Container and the tray. Isn't it? So you can have a set which is having all. From those 11 sets, okay, you have to have one boy, one girl here. You see earlier had one boy and one girl can come, and it will make a set which comprises at least one element from all those 11 sets. Isn't it? Got my point? Am I clear? So that particular set is called a set which is?
Sir, excuse me.
Yes? yes.
Sir, I can't see the board. Sir, I can't see the screen.
Can't see? So that is actually basically a subset which is having the element of all the elements, all the sets. Okay. Now, I will tell you how you can represent a set. How can you represent the set? How can you represent the set? Five elements are there. Okay. Now I can say A is a set. I can represent this in this way. The way you talk, the way we use language. That way, descriptive method I can use. A is a set of numbers, natural numbers, counting numbers, which is less than, it is having some numbers which is more than 1 and less than 16. It is having 5 elements and they are numbers each of which is more than 1 but less than 16. So I can write this way. So this is the way of describing a set in language form, in a descriptive form. But it may so happen that I have to do it in a different form, tabular form. Okay. So I can write A is a set. This is actually a tabular form which I have written. Okay. I have written this in a tabular form, but the way I have, listen, the way I have described you, A is a set which is having numbers more than 1 but less than 16. This is a set. This way I have described. And the way I have written here, that is the tabular form. But if I write in a set builder form, that is another form, how can you describe, how can you represent a set? Set builder form, then I will write X
is such that
then such that X is more than 11 a 1 and X is less than 16, isn't it? But do you think that the tabular form is correct? What should be the correct? Okay. In order to express that in this form, I have written. But if you want to go from this set builder form to that tabular form, what should I write in the table? I need to correct the tabular form, isn't it? What should be the tabular form? What should be the tabular form? If this is your set builder form, A is a set of numbers, X greater than 1, at the same time X less than 6, then what should I write? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay. So this many numbers should be here. But what did I earlier write? I have written 2, 5, 9, 10, 12, like that. So those are actually coming here. But if we have to describe that, then all the numbers, A is a set of all the numbers which is more than 1 but less than 6. Okay, so this is how you can represent a set. You can represent a set in many ways. Three ways are there. The way you speak, the way you describe something, the way we talk. A is a set of numbers which is more than 1. Set of natural numbers which is more than 1 but less than 16. This is the descriptive method. Next comes tabular method. The way you have written, A is a set. Within curly braces you have to write those many numbers. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And what is the set builder form? Or the ruler method? X is more than 1 but less than 16. Okay? So this is set builder form or rule form. So am I clear? So have you got Good and okay. To start with, have you got a good idea of sex?
Yes. Yes.
So, if I tell you to do something with sex, okay? Now, in your class room, you have got so many students. That will be your task after you go home, after you go back to your school. That will be your task. How many different sets you can have among the number of students in your class? Try to categorize them in different, try to act. Assign so many different properties and you can have a different set. Boys and girls, okay, brought it to boys and girls. Then I told you, I am doing some examples. Students having height more than 4 feet, less than 4 feet. Students having student having date of birth in the month of March, or student having date of birth in that particular year. Likewise, you can have many categories, many properties of the students from different sets. So that will be your. Now, I will show you something next. Next is I will show you something. For that, I will take you to galleries or Mathematics galleries here. There I will show you. There I will show you something on angles. Something you wanted to learn something on geometry. Angles, triangles, then area of rectangles, squares like that. Okay. But I think you need to go there in groups. How many students are there?
25.
Okay. In 3 groups. Okay, we will divide them into 2 groups. One group remained here and then. Because you have to go back home.
Play with maths, so I say, in the second category,